Tuvalu, a small island country in the South Pacific Ocean, is succumbing to the adversities brought about by climate change. Diminishing land due to sea level rise, hotter and drier periods of weather are some of the devastations resulting from climate change. These issues are pressing as Tuvalu is likely to experience higher air and sea surface temperatures, more sea level rise and saltwater invasion. And these factors cast a dark cloud over the livelihoods of Tuvaluans in terms of food and water security.
There have been a lot of changes, and these changes are getting more and more serious. And there is only one message, and that is the uncertainty of livelihoods on Tuvalu.
Climate change is making the traditional way of living hard for the people of Tuvalu, as dry spells of weather and seawater intrusion have adverse effects on traditional plantations and fertile land, while migration to the main island of Funafuti and also to other neighboring Pacific countries has been a solution for some. Others are staying put, resisting to leave their motherland. It is only fitting for all of us to engage in the fight against climate change, for we all are bound to be faced with similar problems in time to come. While some experts claiming that Tuvalu will be uninhabitable by 2050, it is only fair for us as Pacific Islanders to ask a simple yet vital question. What are we gonna do about it?
You've got to look at renewable energy, a new mix of energy sources in order to save the globe, the planet. Relocation is not an option. Because by moving people, for example, Tuvalu people to say a bigger country, you are not stopping climate change. You're simply moving them, forgetting about their cultures, their properties, their sovereignty rights, and their rights to live on their island to somewhere else. It's a very self-defeating proposal. And for as a leader of Tuvalu, I totally reject that.
For example, like planting of palakapits, there's a lot of changes taking place, because before we used to dig and plant the palakapits, and nowadays because sea level rise is affecting most of our plantation that we do. So yeah, it's like it changes the way we plant crops and all that.
Before we get the water from the well, our well size is somewhere 2 to 3 meters radius. Before the water was fresh water, natural and tasty, very tasty. Well, compared to nowadays, we are no longer using well because getting affected by sea also, and getting affected by septic tank. Because in Tuvalu we use septic tank almost in all houses. That's the same question I've been asking for all my life. You know, Tuvalu is like, we were born there. We've been raised in Tuvalu, so Tuvalu is like our motherland for us. We hope overseas they can understand us. They have a heart for us, they have a feeling for us, that we can, in a way that we can survive in the future, and hoping that next generation they can do something about this.
As a government, we are, our first budget is coming within a month. And I have put in there a Tuvalu Survival Fund, a trust fund, to start off a fund that the people can rely on to help them adapt to the effects of climate change, provide for their water, improve their gutterings in their houses, piping, and so on. But the problems are enormous. The challenges are so huge for a small island country like Tuvalu. So the message is simple. You know, we need to save Tuvalu. And by doing so, we will save the world. You cannot save the world unless you save Tuvalu.
While there are many steps in the fight against climate change, it is clear that we need to raise more awareness on this issue. solidarity among specific island country leaders will be vital in order to sustain the livelihoods of its people in the future.